Hey guys, this is Yuli89 and welcome to my post Let's Play review of Dragon Ball Z Buu's Fury for the Game Boy Advance. It's taken me 40 episodes to get through this game, and just to clarify, this review is strictly an opinion, so if your opinion differs, keep it to yourself as I won't read it, let alone pay any attention to it. Now, stick with me as I review this RPG, shall we? Now this game's controls is pretty much pick up and play, but to learn the basics there are tutorials. It does seem a little unnecessary for fans of the franchise who already know the game, which this game does seem intended for. But for newcomers to the games, it's helpful. But this game's battle system is still real-time, which is still perfect for it. But it's easy to become overwhelmed early on by some enemies, although this is equaled out by extremely weak enemies and an easy leveling system, so there's no need to heal with. But there are going to be some points in the game where you are going to need to use the healing items, but that will only ever happen if you are underleveled, which I was in the last fight, admittedly, but that was just for more entertainment value. Now in the game there are 5 characters, but they might as well all be the same bloody character because they're all the same in most aspects, because you get the transformations too early on in the game and they're too easily exploited. All you've got to do is run around and wait for the bar to refill. Now whenever you go Super Saiyan, your energy does replenish, but it does deplete slowly. Now this is where one of my biggest gripes with the game is, the energy attacks. Throughout the game they do get stronger, but at the beginning of the game, they're too weak to actually do anything. And you get so used to using the melee attacks, you'll only ever use the energy attacks to amuse yourself with, which I did from time to time. Overall, in terms of gameplay, it's an overly simplified system with weak enemies and overpowered melee attacks. It's good enough for kids, but it won't satisfy anyone who's played the Budokai games. The music in this game is varied to say the least, but after a while it does all sound the same. At first you're glad to hear some new music, but after about 20 minutes in the same area, the music does become pretty boring and could do with something new every now and then. One problem this game has is that at some key points the happy-go-lucky music stays on, in places when it needs some more tense or more atmospheric music. It does do this every now and then, but then it's not enough for people who are looking for things to pick at like me. Find this just a little bit annoying. Now as I said, the music is varied, but you will more than likely hear the same thing more than once, and forgive it for its small faults, but these faults you may find yourself listening to different music to give yourself something to listen to. I preferred Screamer because it just dulled out the dull music in this game. Well, it's Dragon Ball Z, and the game does do a good job of replicating the Dragon Ball universe, but it does have a few things intertwined from the main story, such as the 2 movies from the expanded universe of Dragon Ball Z, which are Broly's Return and the Fusion Reborn movies. Now they do fit in pretty well, but they don't seem necessary to the overall game. It feels like they're just put there to add some time, but the game's presentation itself is okay, what I would expect from a Game Boy Advance game. Now the areas are quite varied. There are some little puzzles. They are made overly simple for children, but they're still there. And a few mini-games and side quests are also there, but unless you're a completist, you don't need them to finish the game itself, but the added power and the added items does help for the final battle. Overall, I'd say the presentation is about normal. Not brilliant, not bad, but there are a few sprite and animations that just a tad slow that you will notice, but overall it's not bad. Now as for a conclusion, this is my first review and I feel I've been fair. Now as for a score, I won't be doing scores, viewers, I will be doing a try it or buy it. Now I am a Dragon Ball fan, so don't get me wrong on this. Now even as I write this review, I'm watching it right now, but this is strictly a fanboy's game. There's barely any backstory or history given apart from the opening. The game is good to play and feels varied enough to keep you playing until the end, but the only challenge actually comes at the end of the game. If you're over leveled throughout the game, it eliminates any challenge given and feels too easy, but it does a better job at recreating the Dragon Ball universe than something else. But as for my try it or buy it, I would say for a fan intended game, I would say buy it. Only for the sake of a fan. If you're new to the franchise, I would say not to play this game unless you have some knowledge of Dragon Ball Z. I hope you enjoyed this review, and this is Yule89 saying keep watching and subscribe.